your email address on there. I got a good word for you today. Everybody look at your neighbor and say, this is going to be a good one. It's going to be a good one. They've been slaves for 400 years. For 400 years, slavery. You're a slave. Your parents, slave. Your grandparents on both sides, slaves. Your aunts, your uncles, slaves. Every person in every photograph you've ever taken, you tell me, what are they? Slaves. Every person in every video you've ever shot, tell me, what were they? Slaves. Because that's the only perspective they had had for 400 years, slavery. How did they get there? They're God's chosen people. Well, it's simple. Disobedience. God never fails to bless obedience. But he is so righteous and so just, he allows the consequence of disobedience. And their disobedience, God's people, the children of Israel, have found themselves in slavery, Egyptian slaves, 400 years. And then God says, I'm going to bring you out. I'm going to get you out. In fact, I have a promised land for you. I have a land flowing with milk and honey. You're going to drink from a well you didn't dig. Anybody here ever dug a well? You have, that's serious business. I'm talking about no backhoes back then. You're digging a well. They said you'll drink from a well you didn't dig. You'll eat from a vineyard you didn't plant. You live in a 5,000-10,000 square foot home you didn't have to buy or pay for in any way, shape, or form. And I'm going to give it to you. And so God raised Moses up. Did Moses want to go? No, God told him, go talk to Pharaoh. Moses didn't think he could. How many of you have ever felt like you can't? You'll find that's who God is closest to. Rarely does he use the most talented, the strongest, the fastest, the best looking. Look throughout Scripture. It's people who said, I can't. I don't think I can. Moses was like, I. And God said, you can and you will. And so Moses goes and tells Pharaoh, let my people go. After a fashion. I'll fast forward here the cliff notes. After a fashion. He releases them. When they come out, it's only days to the promised land. But what did they begin to do immediately? Whining. Actually, they wondered first. Let me hear y'all say wondering and whining. How many of you know they go hand in hand? Wonder why we're out here. I mean, maybe we had to make bricks without straw, but at least we had something to eat. And now the birds are going to peck my baby's eyes out. They started whining. They started grumbling. They started griping. In fact, they chose 12 men to go in and look at the land God had said, I'll give you, just to see if God was telling the truth. If you know the story, they came back. How do you evaluate property today? Anybody in real estate? What are the three words they talk about with a piece of real estate? Location, 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 curb appeal. Well, that wasn't what it about was in. The way you evaluated land was by the fruit that it produced. And so the 12 went in and they came back. You ever picked up a cluster of grapes? It's like this. The Bible says when they came back with that cluster of grapes, they had on a stick that two men bore across their shoulder, like bringing a deer back to camp. They came back and the people said, look at the grapes. Would you look at the grapes? How many of you know if that's all they'd have done was exclaimed how wonderful the grapes were, because that proved the land they'd been in agreement with God. But if you know the story, the 12, 10 of them anyhow, came back and said, well, the grapes are good. However, we feel compelled to tell you that there are men over there who correspond in size. They eat the grapes. And for this reason, we've done a feasibility study, and we really feel like, and they disagreed with God. And God said, fine, remember, disobedience. God never blesses disobedience. And so the Bible says they wandered for 40 years until all but the two men who had gone in and agreed with God and said, our God is well able. Let us go in and possess the land. Caleb and Joshua. They're the only two that went in. But how many of you know once they crossed over the Jordan River, Jericho was still over there. There's still giants there. Jericho, arguably the most formidable city on the planet, with fortified walls. God said, it's there, it's yours. But how are they going to get it? The Bible told Joshua, have the people march 6 times. On the 7th time, let them shout a shout of praise. Let me hear all of you shout on 3. 1, 2, 3. And when they shouted their praise, God gave it to them. If you know the story, the Bible said that when they came out of Egypt, they came out blessed. How many of you ever heard, I come out blessed, I go in blessed? Let me hear everybody on this side of the room.
Come out blessed.
Let me hear y'all say, I go in blessed. Where'd that come from? This story. You see, when they left Egypt, and how long had they been slaves? 400 years. When they left Egypt, the Bible says they plundered. What does it mean to plunder? Take everything of value. I just told you the answer. Let me ask like you, I didn't know. Tell me, church, what does it mean to plunder? To take everything of value. The Bible says they took all the gold and silver and the finest raiment. What's raiment? Clothes. Imagine you're a slave. You've been a slave all these years, and now you go to your slave mistress, the woman, and you say, have you heard? We're leaving. I don't know if you heard, we're leaving. However, I have always had that Versace gown that your husband got you. I'm going to take that with me. Oh, and the earrings he gave you for your 30th anniversary. I've loved those. I'm going to wear those. Don't you think they look good? Oh, and my husband told me to tell you the Armani suit that your husband wears, he'd like to wear that with the shoes dyed to match. When they left Egypt, they plundered. They left with all the gold, with all the silver, and the finest raiment. We used to say styling and profiling. They're only moments away to the promised land, but they wonder and they whine. And God says, fine. You got a better way? Die in the desert. And they did. When they got over the Jordan River, Joshua and Caleb are there. They march around Jericho. The walls fall. But the Bible says Joshua died. There were still more Canaanites to deal with, and the people freaked. What are we going to do? Joshua's dead. Moses dead. What are we going to do? Could you pull up the book of Judges, chapter 1, verse 1, if you have your Bible? Turn to Judges, chapter 1, verse 1. They didn't know I was going to do this until moments ago, nor did I. Judges, chapter 1. Judges, chapter 1, verse 1. The Bible said, here they are. They're over there. They've already possessed much of the land, but there's still Canaanites there, and Joshua dies. And the people freak, and they go to God, and they say, who's going to lead us? How are we going to go in and take the rest of the land? And God said to them, send in Judah. I want to send in Judah. Can anybody tell me, what does the word Judah mean? It means praise. Thank you, brother. Flesh and blood didn't reveal that to you. It means praise. God said, send in the praisers. Now, for time's sake, let me connect the dots for you here. How many of you noticed we started service with praise? Is it because we just don't know what to do with the first 30 minutes of service? Well, I mean, we've got all those guitars and those musicians and the mics. And let them sing a while. Sing another one. Sing another one. No. We start service with praise because we're trying to help you get your mind off of you. The Bible says the joy of the Lord is our strength. Agreed? But how many of you know there are many things that try to rob you of your joy? Agreed? How many of you know rarely is it demons and devils? Oh, we'd like to blame it on hail. But rarely are your problems from hail. Church I grew up in, hell had two syllables. Let me hear y'all say, hey, yo. Rarely do your problems actually emanate from hell. My experience with humanity is typically most of their problems are occurring from a region that's roughly from like here to generally here. It's the command module. And so we would like to blame our problems on hell. That's the problem. But typically the problem is we haven't got our thought life under control. We think about ourselves too much. I can look at people and tell by their posture if they think about themselves too much. I don't have discernment. I have a wife for that, you understand. I'm talking about I can just look. because people who think about themselves too much, they kind of bent over like this. How many of y'all have seen that? My car payment's due Wednesday. Oh, Lord. Their inner Eeyore comes out. Oh, Lord. Oh, God. Okay, you wrote a check for how much? Oh, God. And your mother's coming over Sunday? Oh, God. Oh, God. The more you think about yourself, the more it robs you of your joy. That's why we start with praise. We're trying to get you to get your mind off of you. And so it was with God. I've got a promised land for you. You want to know how to go get it? Start with praise. Praise is the beginning. Praise is your answer. When you can't make your car payment, when your house payment's past due, when you get that result of the MRI, what now? Praise. Praise. Praise opens the doors you can't. So the people said, how can we go in? And God said, send in Joshua. Now, why is this important? Because we live in a culture today that you have been trained from the time you were a child that you don't celebrate until you score the touchdown. In fact, how many of you have seen these guys? He makes an INT. He runs 99 yards with the interception. But he's styling, and he throws the ball down a foot before the goal line. And everybody starts fussing. Wait till you get into the end zone, sucker, before you celebrate. Because we've been trained, you've been trained throughout your life, that you don't celebrate till you win. But how many of y'all, that's natural? And if there's anything in this Christian life you need to know, it's this. God wants you to move from the natural to the supernatural. Let me y'all say, from the natural. Come on, all of y'all didn't say it, and you're out of the will of God if you don't. Don't make me come back there, sir. Let me hear y'all say, from the natural. Impressive. Let me hear all y'all say, to the supernatural. You got to shake that head up. All right, I'm going to give y'all another run now that you know. God wants us to move.
From the natural to the supernatural.
It's true. It's natural to wait until after you are victorious to celebrate. We don't have the parades in the natural till after you win the World Series, till after you win the championship. But God said, I'm a little different deal. I want you to celebrate in advance. Send in the praisers. That's how I got you there. That's how Jericho's walls fell. And that's how you'll get your promised land today. It starts, you tell me what you start with, church. We sing a song, maybe you heard it. When the Spirit of the Lord moves upon my heart, I'm going to shout like David shouted. When's the last time you saw somebody in church shout like David shouted? How about when he danced? If you knew the story, he threw his clothes off and started dancing. His wife looked down there and said, would you look at that? That's David. She fussed at him. What's wrong with you? How many of you husbands have ever had your wife say that to you? Every man in this room. Look at any married man, doesn't have his hand up right now, he's lying through his nose. What is wrong with you? He said, woman, I hadn't even got started praising. Stick around. Stick around. You'll see how I roll. And you see, God never changes. Earlier, Rob said, that's his love. It never changes. It's perpetual. God doesn't change anything. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. So if from that moment he said praise is the key to your victory, wonder how it is in 2017. Praise. What's your name, brother? Tony. What's the key to your life? Is this your wife? Give him, if not the elbow, give him the look next time. You're familiar with the look, aren't you, Tony? Yes. Yes, he is. In fact, when I said that, he was doing what every man does at a time like that. Just don't make eye contact. Just don't look. Don't look. What's your name? Eugenia. What's the answer to you and Tony's problems?
Praise.
Yeah. Finances?
Praise.
Health and well-being?
Praise.
General outlook? When you're disappointed?
Praise.
Angry?
Praise.
Frustrated? I just want to be mad a minute. Yeah. Praise. Say this to me. Praise opens the doors that I can't. Say it again.
Praise opens the doors that I can't.
You tell me, to celebrate after the touchdown is
natural.
But to celebrate in advance is
supernatural.
And God wants us to move from the
natural
to the
supernatural.
They said, who should we send in? God said, send in Judah. Bow your heads, close your eyes. Every one of you in this room, when you said yes to Jesus, you got his DNA deposited into you. The DNA of God. You got the Zoe life of God deposited into you. And part of that life is knowing the power of praise. Knowing the power of praise. There was a song years ago that said, when you praise him, all the chains that bind you fall helplessly behind you. When you praise, we start service with praise so you can get your mind off of you. That's my challenge to you today. As you're seated out there right now, many of you walked in here with a heaviness. You worried about what you're going to go back to when you go home this afternoon. What you're going to face when you get to work this week. What's going to happen at the end of this month. You're worried about next month. How are we going to do this? You've got an sundry of things that seem so large, that have mounted up, that you don't know how you're going to overcome it. God said, is there anybody named Judah in the house? Do I have any praisers? Because that is how you'll not only win this victory, but every victory hereafter, when you praise. I want you to keep your heads bowed. I want you to keep your eyes closed. I want you to raise both hands. Both of them. As we used to say in the streets, both of them. And I want you to thank God right now for loving you. Thank him that your best days are the ones ahead of you. Thank him that your most prosperous days are the ones ahead of you. Thank him your happiest days, your healthiest days, your most productive days. You tell me, church, where are they? They're ahead of you. Thank him today that you may have challenges. There may be giants in your land, but you came out blessed and you're going in blessed. He got you out of 400 years of slavery, and now you're going to walk into high places. You're going to rule and reign with him in this life, the head and not the tail, above and never beneath, a lender, not a borrower, and everything you put your hands to is going to prosper. Everywhere you put your feet, he said, I'll give that ground to you. When you praise, anything is possible. Anything, anything, anything. As you go through the rest of your day, I'm not going to jump to this week. We just need to take captive our thoughts for today. As you go through the rest of this day, every time a thought wells up in your mind, I can't, we're not going to make it, we're going under. Every car I get tears up. I don't know why I'm going for this interview. They're not going to hire me. I've messed up again. I've lost another job. You remind yourself that God never changes. He said, you put praise first, anything, anything, anything can happen. When you lift your hands up and you praise me, I open the doors. I cause your enemy to fall on their own sword. You won't even have to do anything. And you'll come out the head and not the tail. Father, I just thank you that your word is true. I take you the one simple verse we've looked at today. I pray it be sown into the hearts of these people in such a way there's not enough demons in hell to root it out of them. Father, that when they go out of this place this morning, when they walk out of those double doors, they'll remind themselves every day, I have moved from the natural to the supernatural. I walk in the supernatural. I walk in high places. I rule and reign with him in this life. That is my story. Let me hear you say, and I'm sticking to it. Amen. 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 Can we give God glory? Let's go on and do it. If we're going to do it, do it. I appreciate the opportunity to just speak into your life. I don't know if you normally do it. I encourage you to stick around for second service. Look at your neighbor and say, we have church at 11:15 too. Now, some of you didn't say anything. You're looking at me in shock. Twice? Twice? I grew up in church. We used to have Sunday morning, Sunday night, Wednesday night, Tuesday night, Thursday night. Couldn't wait to get there. For 29 years that I've been in travel ministry, I've ministered every place I've ever been the same way. An offering. Not to churches I've never been to and not to my closest friend have I ever said, you have to give me this or I won't come. The Lord told me years ago, son, don't tell them what you think, tell them what you said. I'll tell them to bless you. And so what I ask you today is simply that. I believe God will speak to your heart. You may not know me beyond what I've shared with you in this 20 or 25 minutes. But you don't have to know me. You know him. And that's how God works. And so what I'm asking you today is whatever he speaks to your heart, please be obedient. Amen. Steve, come on. We're just going to play a song as they do this last offering, brother.
Did you enjoy that? Kim always comes with insight, with revelation. I encourage you to go by the table, get some of his teachings. It will change your life. He's a great teacher, world-class musician, singer, and he's going to come back in just a moment and share some more of those sanctified blues. You like that? Amen. We have been friends a long time. We go way back. I know a lot of things on him. He knows a lot of things on me. We're going to leave it right there. But we've been great friends for a lifetime. Everybody needs at least one friend. And we've been friends since I was 7 years old. Now, he's only five. He was only five. I was seven. So I'm 2 years older than him, but I always say he looks 10 years older than me now. I'm 120 now. He's 130. We are going to worship the Lord with a gift. I want to give you an opportunity just to bless him and his ministry. And what he said is true. I don't bring in people that, you know, they require $10,000 or $20,000. We've given offerings like that over the years, but it's because God spoke to somebody and they responded. But we want to bless him because he goes to ministries all over the country and even outside the country. And if we can bless him really good today, then he can go to some places that might not have the finances to bring him in. So, as he said it very good, just ask the Lord, what would the Lord have you to give today? And whatever that is, if you'll just obey him, God will meet the needs that are here. So would you do that right now as we pray? Just ask the Lord what he would have you to give. Father, we thank you for your blessings. We ask that you speak clearly to every person here to give whatever it is that you would have them to give today. I pray, God, that as we ask you, you will speak. And we will hear clearly and we will respond in obedience to your word. And we give you thanks in Jesus' mighty name. Amen and amen. Now, whatever the Lord spoke to you to give today, if you would just do that, write a check. You can make your checks to Metro Tab. You can give online. You can use the app. You can use an envelope in the seat pocket in front of you and fill that out. If you would just take a moment and do that. And then they're going to play. And if you would, come and bring your gift. We have Bridge Builders down front, as well as other places in the room for your convenience. And then we will dismiss together in just a moment at the end of this song. Would you stand? And would you worship the Lord? Is that all? You're not going to sing? We got a mic set up over there for you, and you're not going to sing? Get your guitar on. Go over there and sing a little bit. They can leave if they want to. We got a few minutes before the next service. Don't you want to hear him sing? You'll need that card. You'll need that chord.
All right, brethren, we're in E.
Put your hands together.